I'm here on the banks of one of Britain's world rivers. Now this river is not only home to fish, but also all sorts of other creatures. And it's a particularly special river, and I'm going to show you why. This section of river is fast flowing. It's rich in oxygen, and there are lots of these, which provides the perfect structural habitat for invertebrates. Wow, this rock's absolutely coated in different invertebrates. We've got caddisfly here, cased caddis. We've got uncased caddis. There's some mayflies rushing about on this side. Here's one right here. It's just absolutely covered. And to think that every single rock in this riffle has got a similar number of these on. Just a huge amount of food in here. And it's this that really supports so much of the river life here, from the dippers that dive amongst these rocks, the fish, even the otters, because the otters are eating the fish and the fish are eating these. It's just remarkable. Just over the tree here, there's a lovely looking bit of water. I wanted to get above it so I can look down and see if there might be a fish holding up there that I can have a cast for. This tree is just perfect for me to get up above, a bit like an osprey, and look down. And if I do see one, I'll be able to plan my approach and come back. And if I don't, well, then I'll move on up the river. Here we go then. Well, it's hard to say, but I think I might have seen a fish there. They look so much like the riverbed, like the pebbles, they've got such good camouflage that it's really difficult to tell, but there is something just drifting in the current that's possibly a bit of weed, a bit of debris, or a fish. So I'm going to go around and see, put my flies over and see if I get a response. I've got here a beautiful wild brown trout. The fish on the usk here have quite a distinctive pattern of these fantastic leopard spots, which all brown trout have, but they have this fantastic blue sheen just on the gill plate here, which is quite idiosyncratic of this river. Trout in different rivers tend to have different patterns, and these fish are very easy to identify. Absolutely beautiful. Wild brown trout like this are absolutely delicious. And it's very tempting to take this one for the pot. But we can't kill every fish we catch, or there wouldn't be any for the future. And the trout population in this river, like the ecosystem, is quite fragile. So this one's going to go back. We've seen just a glimpse of this beautiful river today and the creatures that live here. There's so much more to see as well, under the water, in the trees, along the riverbanks, and throughout the whole length of this river. The future of these rivers, though, is uncertain, and it's in our hands. We've got to look after them, we've got to protect them, and make sure they're here for future generations.